I really like hard questions segment. And you know, we have a half hour program too that we do where we get really deeper into the questions. Yeah. But what this is, it's the opportunity for you to send in questions to pastors and say, what about this? What about that? You may not even want to ask your real pastor because you may just don't want to get that with him, or maybe you don't have a pastor. That's what this whole segment's about. So I respect and honor the office of a pastor. I believe it's this office is called by God to lead the church. And so what a privilege it is to have Dr. William Glaze with us on the far right, anchoring the right side of the line from Bethany Baptist in Pittsburgh. Pastor Pete Giacalone from Rainbow Temple in McKeesport, Pennsylvania. Pastor Chris Gibbs from Crossways Church in Valencia on the far left, brother. Oh.
I know, that's a designation I'm kind of struggling with.
And our special guest pastor from Tampa, Florida, Pastor Keenan Bridges from Grace and Peace Global Fellowship. We're so glad that you're with us.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
So glad that you guys are with us. Let's go right into this first question. It's in keeping with the day.
Yep.
In keeping with the Holy Week, why do some call this day Maundy Thursday from church history? Who can pick it up?
Maundy actually is a Latin word,
yeah,
and it means commandment.
Mm-hmm.
And it signifies when Jesus was with the disciples and he gave them the commandment to love one another.
That's it. Mm-hmm.
So that's basically the reason that we have Maundy Thursday.
And it's also known as Covenant Thursday, Great and Holy Thursday, and Thursday of Mysteries. Mm. That's some of the other.
Mm. Yeah.
Well, on this day, what was the key significant happenings on this day in Passion Week, Chris?
Yeah, well, I mean, obviously you have the Last Supper that Jesus celebrated with his followers. But even more than that, if Maundy means command, is it a commandment that we celebrate this day on the Thursday before Good Friday? Or is it what I believe the command where Jesus said, love one another, serve one another? This whole idea with Peter, when he takes off, you know, the outer garment and puts on the towel. See, we've talked about this before. The problem with being a servant is when you get treated like one. But Jesus was teaching them, this is how you serve.
Servant's
do
heart.
This to one
yeah.
another.
Yeah.
Love one another.
Yeah.
Wash feet. Even Hebrew slaves weren't commanded to wash feet. Mm. Do this because this is an act of loving Jesus. This is an act of being a follower.
Yeah.
Well, Pastor, how's that fit for you?
Well, I think it also represents humility and abasing ourselves. And that's one of the things, you know, in order to love one another, we have to walk in that humility. We have to walk in compassion one toward another. And especially, you know, we are all pastors on this panel. That's really what it's all about. It's serving the flock, serving. And as we serve the flock can learn to serve one another.
I was thinking about that evening, you know, as I mentioned in the opening, Jesus had celebrated Passover all his life.
Yes.
Passover is one of the traveling feasts. So every man in Israel was commanded to come to Jerusalem.
Had to be there.
So he had done that all his life.
Right.
And so here he is, and they had made arrangements, and they were engaged in something that was very, very comfortable for them.
Right.
This wasn't an unusual thing.
But it
became unusual, Pastor.
Yeah. Yeah, it became unusual, and one of the reasons that it became unusual because it was the last time, you know, before his death that he would spend time with the disciples.
That's right.
And he was actually, you know, preparing them for his death, and also that the fact that he would come back and rise again.
Yeah.
So it was special in that way. And then the other thing that I think when we talk about the love thing, and at that very night was the night that Judas betrayed him. Judas was right there at that supper, and Jesus, you know, talking about love one another, Maundy, the commandment to love, that Jesus loved Judas, though he betrayed him.
Exactly.
And when you think about this, when you talk about Passover and things like that, you're talking about a covenant meal. At that time, you ate meals with your friends and those that you were in covenant with. So this was one of the last times they had to fellowship with Jesus and to covenant with him. And it reminds me of what David wrote in Psalm 23. It says, I prepared a table before you in the presence of your enemy. You see this covenant going on, and it's just a testament that our responsibility is to obey God and to follow Him and to honor Him, and God takes care of the rest, you know, in terms of
going back
our relationships.
To what you were saying about all the feasts of the Passover come up to Christ, and then all of a sudden it pinpoints Christ. You have Christ seated there, and then Christ says, "You know what? It's time for a new covenant."
That's right. That's
you know,
good.
It's a brand new, and so for thousands of years, and then now at this supper, Jesus gives a brand new institution. Yep. He's saying, because of his, you know, a covenant isn't sealed unless it's blood.
That's
so
right.
It all pinpointed, all the lamb sacrifice pinpointed to Christ. Now Christ is actually saying, it's coming to full fruition right here, right now. And now we're going to change it.
And the thing I like about that, too, going with that and with what you were saying, and, you know, conversations we were having in the green room earlier, as far as when God does something in you, do something with it.
Right.
So all of this is good, new covenant, all of this is great. What do you do with it? And the thing I like is before this, and you see it in some of the other Gospels, Jesus sent and made preparation.
Right.
See, this is not, this doesn't just happen because you feel like it or because you don't feel like it. There's preparation. So our command to live this out is serve one another. You got to prepare your heart. You got to prepare yourself because you're not going to always feel like serving.
That's
you're not going to always feel like being treated like a servant. You're not going to always feel like loving. But you do this. You prepare your heart. You prepare your life.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, I was going to say this, that, you know, during this week also, we celebrate the triumphal entry.
That's right.
But it really wasn't the triumphal entry. Mm. Jesus rode in on the same day they selected lambs for the Passover.
Right.
So when Jesus rode into the city, he was saying, here's the Lamb of God.
Yeah.
He
right
rode
there.
In to offer himself as that perfect lamb, and knowing that Friday that he would be the lamb that was crucified on the cross.
It was that next day that lamb that was selected was slain on that next day before sunset.
Right. Yes, it had to be.
On the altar, that lamb was slain. In fact, then thousands of lambs were slain after that.
Yeah.
But that select lamb was slain precisely at the same time that Jesus died on the cross on Golgotha.
Amen.
His blood at 3 o'clock that afternoon, as it was shed, exactly the time when the priests in the temple were slaughtering the lamb. See, that's God. That's
right,
God, brother, you know.
Praise the Lord.
And it goes on to the resurrection. It goes on to the 7 days of unleavened bread.
Amen.
It just goes all the way through here. Jesus fulfilled the Passover.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Then he fulfilled Pentecost, another traveling feast, and he's yet to fulfill Tabernacles.
Mm.
But we're going to see him fulfill Tabernacles really quickly. Guys, great, great answers, great insight and revelation. We're so glad that you tuned in to watch this. And if you like hard questions, send us one. These guys will take any question. Which is really, we used to do them and we didn't tell them what they were.
Oh my gosh.
They said, sit down and we just pop them on them. You know, we don't do that anymore. We give them the preparation time and the prayer time. But send your questions, the hard questions at ctvn.org. Get ready. We're talking about the Jewish world. We're talking about Jewish tradition. We've got an interview with Barry Siegel that's going to be really powerful. You're going to see what God's doing in the Holy Land.
Wow.
So you don't want to go away. We'll be right back.